Okay, sun's shining and it's oil change time. Rohloff recommend we do this every 3,000 miles, 5,000K or once a year. And it's definitely time to do it.
So here, we've got the cleaning fluid. Here is the oil. Now I'll mention, anybody with a Rohloff hub is probably aware of this, but Rohloff have changed their recommendations of how much to use. Back in November 2023, they actually advise you only use half. Their hubs will apparently work with virtually nothing, and so it's a bit more environmentally friendly. In the kit, we also get instructions in case we forget, which we probably will. Very handy to be able to remind us. And then this is the tool we use, the syringe, which will put in the cleaning fluid, remove the dirty fluid, and then reinsert with the oil. Okay. Doesn't take too long. So we've put the bike or the back wheel on a nice bright pink piece of cloth. Two reasons. Obviously we're doing it outside, but it still protects my sister's patio. And also when we take it out, if it drops, which quite likely it could do, it shouldn't run away and disappear. First of all, we've got to spin the wheel so we can see, and it's just in there. Can you see, Tom? That's what we're going to remove. And I should have 3mm Allen key in my hand. Before we remove it though, I'm going to give the rub the hub round, because I don't want to add extra muck inside and it could easily drop in. It is in a slightly awkward position and I don't have the strongest of hands. I'm going to try and get it turning with the Allen key in this position. Really make sure, yeah, you can hear it sort of click into place, you can feel it. Nah, I can't make it that move. So I'm going to have to try coming in like this. Got to find it, you can put it in somewhere where you've got room. There we go, I can see that, feel that nice little click as it seats in properly. And then you've got more room here to push it. Yeah, there we go. So it's just been a bit patient. I'm going to give it another little turn. After three or four insertions with the Allen key flat, I've managed to slacken it off enough that I can now turn it with it upright, which is much, much easier. It is in tight, and remember that Loctite makes it a really firm, tight fit. Now, sometimes it will stay on the end of your Allen key like that, and I can remove it nice and smoothly, and sometimes you drop it on the floor. The old drain screw, don't just throw it away, you're going to need it again in a few moments. Okay, so put it safely to one side. Then we take our syringe with the hose attached and we need to insert into here all the cleaning fluid and simply extract it all into the tube. Whoops. Doing that, you saw that, or heard rather, that lovely sucking noise. So yeah, pretend you're a nurse and just push the plunger back in. You need to push it a little bit further. You can see that air coming out. What you don't want is to squirt the fluid all over your head. There we go. So once you've lined it up, you want to be turning the hose rather than the whole syringe. And just keep turning until you can feel it bite. So we're going to insert the oil into the hub, okay? And obviously bring on the nurse again and just plunge that in. Now we need to balance the air pressure inside. So we're going to extract about 25 millilitres of air. That should be about right. And then in reverse, we're going to remove it. And then pick up your Allen key. Lovely nut. And very carefully pull put that in position. Extra hand sometimes useful here. There we go. Just steady away. Give the whole area a quick white round. Two reasons: you don't want the oil running every, the cleaning fluid everywhere, but it also makes sure you can see if any is seeping out when you do the soap. Now, to do the soap, if we need to change gears for 3 minutes between gears 3 and 5, and pedaling forward and back. You can go for a little spin, or you can just lift the back wheel up and change the gears here. To pedal forward and back whilst changing gear between 3 and 5. Okay, so after 3 minutes back and forth through the gears, the cleaning fluid has worked its way through the hub. So what we need now is to get it to drain. And by draining it, we will allow all the fluid to sink to the bottom. So this is what we do now. We're going to reattach this. So let's remove that nut. Upright again. Hopefully I've not over tightened it, just tight enough. Yeah, there we go. Now this is technically finished with now. There you see, my little pink cloth worked nicely. And then reattach this as before, get it seated, and then turn the tube. So once that's in, we need to turn the hub so the hole is now pointing down. There we go, maybe a fraction more, brilliant. And then set the timer on your clock for at least 15 minutes. You can actually leave it up to an hour if you've got the time. Go grab a cup of coffee. Okay, so we've given that 15 minutes, and during that time, all the cleaning fluid will hopefully have sunk to the bottom. And now I'm just going to extract it by pulling on the plunger. And you can see this rather grim, mucky looking fluid coming out. You can straighten up the bike, and that makes the hole right at the bottom, and just keep extracting. There we go. Tip that out. Have a tissue ready for when you unscrew it, because it'll still leak a little bit. Off that comes. And just grab, move that quickly, carefully to one side, hold it upright, and just catch anything that's dripping out. And then we're going to spin that wheel back round. There we go. So that's nice and upright. Going to get rid of the mucky cleaning fluid by inserting it into the empty bottle for disposal. Pull and push a few times just to get rid of what's left. We're going to put the oil in, and it's very similar procedure. Put the syringe in there and slowly extract. Now this does screw on quite nice and easy because the threads, same again, turn the tube until you feel it fitting nicely. Yep, there we go. And then just push the plunger. And just remove as I turn it, gets a little bit oily. So there we go. I'm going to clean that off again. A Now this next bit, you might just struggle a little bit because this nut now has brand new thread lock all over it, which makes it a really tight to insert. And the first time we did it, we thought we were cross-threading it. So here we go. Take your time, make sure it's seated in properly and straight. And it is tight. There we go. And it wants to be 3 good turns to flush with the frame.
No deeper.
But no deeper than that. And do the final tighten up. Remember though, make sure you get the Allen key seated nice and snug into the nut. Just take your time.
So once you've got that in, your job's done. Why do we have Rohloff over a derailleur system? Well, all the gears are enclosed in that hub. You can change gear when you're halfway up a hill or stationary, which is fantastic when you're fully laden. And wear-wise, they just go on and on and on. So it's really, really good, convenient not have to be worried about buying new derailleurs. Yeah, you have a chainring and a chain and a sprocket, but they're actually really light to carry with you as well and so simple to fit. But that's for the future. For now, we're ready for off.